This is the 8-track of the original multiple machine that I drew up on an envelope and was turned down by Westrex, and Ampex decided to go ahead and build one. And the first multiple recording is where you play a part and then you add a part to it and you're playing two parts, one person. I did with my mother's player piano where I was punching the holes in it. The second one was with the two recording lathes where I'd record a record here, a guitar, and then play that record back and then record myself live with the record and then put it onto another record. That was the second way. And the third way is where I added a fourth head to a 3-track mono tape machine. Then the idea hit me and I said, I know where it's at. It's to stack up this machine with all 8 tracks. And by making an 8-track machine, you can individually put 1 on 1, 2 on 2, 3 on 3. I can record each part individually. And then the idea came about to conceive a 16-track, which was nothing more than an extension of the 8-track. And so by developing that technique, I can remember when all Hollywood was in my backyard because of this new sound, and that's what they call it. I remember Capitol Records, we called a meeting and they said, what are we going to call this sound you have with the multiple tracks and the echo and the phase shifting and so forth and so on? What are we going to call this close miking technique and so forth and so on, direct to disc and so forth and so on? I said, why don't we call it the new sound?
Tonight's profile of Les Paul, the Wizard of Waukesha, continues on Night Flight right after this.
Bye, bye, blue. I met Mary in 1945, and we got married in 1949. Mary used to sing hillbilly songs. I went to Capitol Records and says, will you change the contract and make this Les Paul and Mary Ford?
Smile, blue. Don't sigh, don't cry, bye.
Mary, no peeking at the last page like you always do. Just try and figure out who did it while we do Song in Blue.
All right.
And I hear a song.
Chet Atkins, I guess it was sometime in the early part of 77, they sent me this boot instead of a gold record, and that's for winning the country award.
And the winner is... I always get to do this, don't I?
Right.
Oh, Chester and Lester. Chet Atkins and Les Paul.
Thank you very much. There are two people that I want to thank. Move away. And I didn't do it on the back of the album, so I want to do it tonight. And that's Roy Horton, a fellow who works for Pierre Southern in New York and is a great fan of country music. And Shel Silverstein, who's one of my dearest friends and helped a lot with the graphics and the cover. Your turn.
I just want to thank my landlady for the lamp she brought down. I just want to thank y'all for being so very kind. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to mention here that a lot of people ask this question, if you could pick one thing, what is it that you would like to be remembered for most? And it would be very difficult because so many things are important at a certain time of your life, and your life changes all the time. And so what is a great thing at one time is no longer that important, and at a later date you've got your head on somewhere else. And I found that when we created the 8-track machine, oh, this is the greatest thing. When the solid body guitar was the greatest thing, and the echo was a great thing, and so forth and so on. And I think entertaining on the stage is a very important thing.
This is Lover, the first hit.
Playing on the stage is probably one of the only times that I feel like if there is a heaven on earth, if there's a heaven on earth, that's when I'm performing. That I don't know who the president is, and I don't know who got arrested, and I don't know anything but how wonderful it is to the ends of your fingers to talk to thousands of people out there in that audience.